It's Brian Preston, the money guy.
This next question, Brian, is from Stu. Stu631. I don't know if the numbers matter. Where should I park money if I want to make a major purchase within a year, like a mortgage down payment? Here's the kicker. Is it better to park it in a target retirement fund or strictly in bonds? Brian, do you have anything to say to that? Where you should park it, and specifically some things to think about as it relates to target retirement funds or bonds being a place to park assets for the next year?
Well, Sue, this is a good question, but it's also one, man, it's such unique times here because, you know, I think it's Warren Buffett who's talked about this. There are times in life where what's perceived as risky can be safe and what is safe can be risky. Mm-hmm. And I can tell somebody like Stu, based upon the way he asked that question, he's trying to maximize. He really is a financial mutant trying to maximize the dollar, but he doesn't want to keep it in the dollar. He's thinking about target retirement mm-hmm. funds. He's talking about bonds. And here's the problem with both of those. First of all, target retirement funds are diversified mm-hmm. portfolios. And if you're using index, even if you're using the ones we talk about, the index target retirement funds, they are going to have a complex basket of investments. Will be stocks, it'll be bonds, be international stocks, and then a little bit of cash or liquidity. There's going to be a lot of volatility potential there. So you don't, I think that rules out, especially for a year. I mean, a year is going to be here before you know it. You blink and 12 months will have gone by and you will need to fund it for this mortgage down payment. You can't have 15, 20, 25% volatility. So that takes out target retirement funds. That's no-go land right there on a year goal. Let's talk about bonds, because bonds feel very safe, just, you know, because we know we put these in the past, we put these in portfolios to give us an anchor of steadiness, even though we know that we're probably signing up for less than long-term market performance. If we just did like the S&P 500, mm-hmm. we're counting on some stability. There is a fly in the ointment on this in the past historical good way to safely grow your money is that we're in a rapidly interest rate rising environment. Mm-hmm. And look, I'm holding this right now. And anybody who's taking your first investment 101, if you have a bond that you buy with an interest rate or a bond fund and it has a basket of interest rates at, say, 3%, and then now rates are at 4%, your value is just like the seesaw showed as I'm holding up this pen, goes down because nobody wants your 3% bonds paying bonds. If they can get 4% out there on the open marketplace, it drives down the value of your bonds. So guess what? Bonds actually can lose money. Yep. I know that it's kind of scary to say that out loud, but it is something that a lot of people are probably recognizing in the through the first quarter of 2022. So if you need this money to be rock solid cash and available liquid to you 12 months from now, it's not bonds, because bonds could lose 5%, they could lose 6%. You know, it's not going to be as much as the stock market. It's not going to be 30, 40% mm-hmm. like the stock market, but it could be you could lose purchasing power with it. So I hate to tell you, Stu, it's going to be boring cash. That's so right. You can now, I would look at how do you maximize that cash. About the best thing you can do right now is probably some of these online banking accounts that have money markets, FDIC insured money markets. And I understand as the Federal Reserve raises interest rates, you might not get the first or even the second interest rate increase in the rates because they're all paying about 0.5% right now. But around that third or fourth rate increase, you will start seeing, because mm-hmm. at first the banks keep the first two or three rate increases for themselves to get the profit up, and then they do start passing it down in future. So I wouldn't be surprised a year from now or even 6 months, 9 months from now, maybe we get our cash savings over 1% to 1.5%, mm-hmm. because it wasn't too long ago we were getting 2.5%
in 2019. Middle of 2019,
we're getting 2.5% on money market accounts. That's where your money, because you know it's going to be safe. You know it's going to be there for you. Yes, some of the purchasing power is probably being devastated by inflation. But if you need that money in a year, there's not a lot of places that you can put it right now that pretty much assure you that it will be there, you know, at the same value. Mm-hmm. I can't say purchasing power, but the same value as it was when you put it in there.